In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, coming together as God's family, let us with contrite hearts acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for His mercy and pardon. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, author of our freedom and of our salvation, listen to the voice of our pleading, and grant that those you have redeemed by the shedding of your Son's blood may have life through you, and under your protection, rejoice forever unharmed.
Amen.
Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Paul came to Antioch in Pisidia, he said in the synagogue, "My brothers, children of the family of Abraham, and those others among you who are God-fearing, to us this word of salvation has been sent. The inhabitants of Jerusalem and their leaders failed to recognize him, and by condemning him, they fulfilled the oracles of the prophets that are read Sabbath after Sabbath. For even though they found no grounds for a death sentence, they asked Pilate to drive him and put him to death. And when they had accomplished all that was written about him, they took him down from the tree and placed him in a tomb. But God raised him from the dead, and for many days he appeared to those who had come up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem. These are now his witnesses before the people. We ourselves are proclaiming this good news to you, that what God promised our fathers, he has brought to fulfillment for us, their children, by raising up Jesus, as it is written in the second Psalm, 'You are my son, this day I have begotten you.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are my son, this day I have begotten you.
You are my son, this day I have begotten you.
I myself have set up my king on Zion, my holy mountain. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. The Lord said to me, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you."
You are my son, this day I have begotten you.
Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for an inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession. You shall rule them with an iron rod. You shall shatter them like an earthen dish.
You are my son. This day I have begotten you.
And now, O kings, give heed, take warning, you rulers of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice before him with trembling rejoice.
You are my son, this day I have begotten you. Please stand.
I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The beginning words of our gospel today, my dear brothers and sisters, gives a lot of comfort since then. Jesus telling us, "Do not let your hearts be troubled." Sa pagsasalin po nito sa Tagalog, sinasabi po sa atin o ang pagsasalin ay ganito: huwag po kayong mabalisa. In a way, if we will understand the words of Jesus, he knows so well that sometimes, human as we are, we get in trouble, we face troubles, and maybe we ourselves are taking in troubles. Ngunit sa araw na po ito, mga kapatid, sinasabi ni Jesus sa atin, "Mapuno ka man ng mga gumugulo ng lakas mo, ako pa din ang natitirang sandigan at lakas mo. You might be in trouble, but I am here to be your strength." Hindi naman po natin ikakaiya na mayroon po tayong iba't ibang mga klase ng gulo o mga bagay na talagang bumabalisa sa atin bilang mga tao. Mainit po ang panahon, ilang linggo na. Dumadagdag pa dyan ang magpapainit ng ating mga ulo sa mga iba't ibang gulo na ating hinaharap araw-araw. To unresolved things inside our homes, maybe unanswered prayers, family trouble, disgust, and so on. Troubles will be there to consume our energy, to cause us pain, and really put us in great trouble. But today, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus wishes to pacify our experience of trouble and lead us to peace. The Lord came giving us a lot of consolations from our gospel today. In our troubles, He said, let us put our faith in Him and into His Father. At kapag may pananampalataya tayo sa gitna ng gulo, may kapanatagan tayo kung maniniwala kahit tayo ay nasa kaguluhan o kabalisaan. In our troubles, Jesus wishes us that we are together with Him. Ayaw niya na tayo po ay maiwan ng basta-basta. Gusto niya, kasama niya ang bawat isa sa atin. In our troubles, the surest way to go back to Him is to know Him and to be with Him again. Baka kaya tayo po ay nababalisa o naguguluhan, sa iba po tayo napunta. Hindi natin nalalaman o hindi na tayo bumabalik muli kay Jesus na daan, katotohanan, at buhay. My dear friends, if we are thinking that we are always in front of God and God seems to offer nothing when we want to be at peace or when we are in trouble, God has a lot of ways like that of today to keep you in peace. Manalig sa Diyos, dumikit sa Diyos, bumalik sa Diyos. Bilang tao, kaya nating maipanatag ang bawat isa. Kaya po nating gawing stable ang nararamdaman ng bawat isa sa ating mga gawain. Pero totoo at buo, ang kapayapaan sa pananalig sa Diyos, sa pagdikit natin kay Jesus, at sa pagbabalik natin kay Jesus.
Please stand.
Let us pray with complete trust in our Father, who in Jesus prepared a place for us in heaven. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may lead the faithful in the ways of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That public servants may become living and effective instruments in the transformation of our society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are troubled by material and financial concerns may seek refuge in our Lord's providential care. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in our bodily or spiritual infirmities, we may all the more depend on God, who wants to grant us total and permanent healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be freed from the troubles of this world and enjoy everlasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and for all the intentions offered in this Mass. For all of these we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father in heaven, grant that we may ever keep our eyes on your house, where we hope to dwell with you forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, my dear brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care, they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain, who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Panginoon, ang aking
Please stand.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Regina Church.